Welcome back, guys. We are at Marina Stadium, me and Duff today. We were on our way to 72nd place, I think it's called. It's a little bit down the street. But yesterday, Noel Arguero hit us up and he left a comment letting us know that we should hit this place up. So hopefully we get something good today. We also want to thank you guys for we're over 200 subscribers now. So that's really tight. We appreciate all the support and all the love you guys have been giving us. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and like and leave a comment because it helps us out for the YouTube algorithm. But yeah, also check out the links below to see any of the things that we use in the video. We'll let you know what we're using. So.
And we'll keep these videos coming for you guys. Oh, look, you see the Stinger?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, dude, I swear I had a bite. Stupid grass. It feels like a bite just because it's hard.
It was the same thing I have. Oh, dude, that was definitely a bite. Oh, hell yeah.
You got a fish?
Yeah.
Yeah? Damn. Oh, dude.
Shit.
That's a good one. Dude, damn.
Dude, this is a pretty big spotty.
That's a good one. Dude, that's a big one.
I think this is bigger than the other ones I got.
Dude, it might be your biggest one. Oh, first fish of the day.
Hey, this spotty's pretty nice, though. Nice little guy.
Maybe 10 inches, 11 inches.
He's a nice fish.
You know.
All right, guys, thanks for playing. Hell yeah. Oh, we know there's fish.
Do we know there's fish, James? Do we?
I guess let me show you how it's done.
People took all the fish in this place. Selfish bitch. Man, there's like a fucking seagrass right there that I keep thinking it's something.
The fish I caught earlier, I got it on a 2-inch Keitech on a 1/8-ounce jig head. I just saw a fish right now.
Like jump or you saw?
No, he was in the water. Like I think he chased my thing for a second.
Where you at, big fella? There is action here, like in the water. But like, it's just like enough to keep you here, but not like enough to get you like, oh fuck.
You just suck, dude. You gotta catch a fish like me. Oh, damn, dude, I lost it. Fuck. Dude, that fool was fighting. I did not set the hook though.
Yeah, Soviet Russia, fish get you.
Here we go, baby.
Come on, baby, come on, baby, come on, baby, come on.
Where's the fish? Where's the fish that hooked on? Who ran away? Nothing?
Nope, no, even a bite.
Cleaning up the ocean.
Calma, lad, Jim. Fuck your line.
Fuck on another fish.
Fuck your line.
Oh fuck, shit, they like ran next to each other. Catch a fish.
I'm trying. Oh, doggy. I'm on the right path. Oh, doggy.
You got him?
No. Again, fishing with one hand only?
Imagine.
The one hand only challenge?
Man, there's a ton of fish here. There's fish everywhere right in front of us. A little ray. Rays are cool, but I don't like catching them. They're like a rock when you try to reel them back in. What you should always have are pliers. Pliers will save you from getting the jig out of the mouth because some fish swallow the fucking jig head. Oh, there's another one, dude. I saw one earlier. Maybe the same fucking one.
Damn, that was a big.
Why couldn't I catch that fish?
It's over there. You see it?
Oh, hell! Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, dude.
Dude, that was a... Dude, he ripped off my jig. Dude. He ripped off my fucking jig head.
Oh, my God, dude.
Oh, shit, that fool was
dude,
big.
Dude, the rod bent like a motherfucker. It was probably a cuda.
Dude, the fish was so big, it ripped off my 8-pound test. Holy
dude,
shit.
It was definitely a barracuda.
Dude, that was tight, though. That was a big one. Dude, if he ripped... He literally munched it and fucking took it off.
Gone, yeah.
Damn.
Man, this thing got the... Like, I was looking at you, and then all I see the rod go...
Yeah, boom? Dummy bent. Fuck. I mean, that was tight, though. Damn, there's fucking monsters out here.
Locked up. They won't let me out. Yeah, I'm going to switch jigs here, too. Because this eighth, I feel maybe it's not getting low, deep enough. Because if you've been throwing a quarter, and you've been getting... You got three bites, that means that yours is lower than mine. That felt like a bite. But it was seaweed, sigilweed, as I like to call it. And Jim's getting all the bites today. Selfish hood rat.
The one that got away.
Kind of my little romantic.
Dude, I suck. That's two fish I missed.
It's better to have caught and lost than to never.
That life. It's all about that boom, 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 boom bass. On the other one, dude, look. That one's small. Throw your thing at it. Can't your car swim? Dude, another fucking ray.
TA's on him. Let's go help the guy out. Get his bass. He got a big ass spotty. Ooh. TA caught a spotty. That's a good one. Tackle it. That's a big one right there. Oh yeah.
Oh dude, that was 100% a fucking bite.
Okay.
Fuck. Fisher, my friend. Dove has to leave in like 20 minutes, so hopefully we can get onto something before he bounces.
This is what I have.
This was just cleaning up the ocean.
All right, James. I'll see you next time.
You're out?
Yeah.
Come on, baby. Big Bertha. I know you're out there. I'll come back for you. All right, guys. We're back here from yesterday at Marine Stadium. I kind of like this spot. You know, I got a fish yesterday and it broke off to hopefully the Big Bertha. I'm coming back for her. But yeah, we're gonna keep on trying with this 2.5-inch Keitech. That's all that I'm using right now. Let's see what happens. There's so many stingrays here. I don't know if you can see it, it's right there. All right, you know what? I gotta make my leader longer. Still pretty long already, but I want it to be at least a good 6 inches longer. This is a 12-pound test on, I'm gonna use the same 1/8-ounce jig head. And recently I've been using a uni knot. I used to use a different knot, but this one's way better. It doesn't slip. I'm gonna put on this 2.5-inch swing impact electric shad. Hopefully this is all I needed to hook on. See, the benefit of having a leader is you see in the water, you can't see the line. See, in the water, the line disappears. But if I were to put it and have my line, you can see this. I'm putting my tip in the water. You can see my line in the water, but you can't see the other one. And you can barely see it. But over the benefits of having a leader, so that the fish doesn't, he knows like, oh, this must be a little fish or something. When he sees the line, chances are they're smart enough to know like, oh, that there's something there, like it's not real or it looks too suspicious. Oh fuck, finally, dude. Oh yeah. What is this? Oh, doggo. Finally, got me a little fish. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, thank you. You want him? Yeah. Oh, he's not that big, but... Oh, man, it's nice to finally get onto a fish. Beautiful spotted bass. All right, guys. Let's let him go. And he swam away so, oh, he's hiding the rock right there. You can see his little tail right there. That's how fish hide in the rocks, because they decide like, oh, this is what's gonna allow us to not get them pulled in or reeled in. They hide in the rocks and make it impossible to get them in. But it was about to be my last cast too, and I'm glad I got onto something. Yeah, you see, a little 2.5-inch Keitech. Let's see if this fish will bite it again. Oh, I'm away. You know, we don't do anything special. We just cast it out, do a different kind of a slow retrieve, fast retrieve, just try different things. What we like to do is kind of, you know, reel, like put the rod up a little bit, like swing it up slowly. Because what happens is that the bait is swimming and has a paddle tail, so there's action. And when you bring it up, when it goes down, it swims down like this. And usually that's where fish bite it. We just try different things. We don't always know what works, but like I said, fishing's a patient game. But it's fun to lure fish with artificial, because Duffin, I think it's rewarding because, you know, we trick the fish. Oh, I'm onto another one. Come on, baby. Damn, finally. What is it, a little spotty? Is it the same one? Oh, it is. It's not the same one, but another one, finally. Open up, open up, open up, open up. He ate my bait. That's not the same one, but it's a beautiful looking fish. All right, buddy, thanks for playing. Look, you see? He hit into the rock again on a Keitech off. It's a grind, but Keitech's always a good thing to use. It's a quarter ounce jig head, but it's kind of like a dart. Usually the ones I use are round, but Duff gave me this one. It's pretty good. I guess Big Bertha, I'll have to come back for her. The one that got away. Hey guys, don't forget that we have links in the description below where you can actually find things like the Keitech, the reels, the rods, the line, the equipment we use to fish. If you guys want to check it out, and maybe it'll do you some luck too. Keitech is usually our favorite thing to go with. It's safe, almost always works. All right, last cast of the day. Hopefully we can catch one more before we leave, or before I leave. The spot is pretty cool though, it's chill. It's a nice little lake, riverbank, whatever this is, pond. I think that's all the fun for today. We'll have to come back and get some more. Well guys, it was fun while it lasted at Marine Stadium. It's a pretty good spot. And yeah, I think his name's Noel Arguero. He's the guy who left a comment on the YouTube channel telling us to check this place out. So yeah, if you guys wanted to check something out, something in the LA area, we'll definitely come on by and check it out when we can and see what we can get here. It's super fun. And we appreciate all the love and support you guys have been giving us. We're over 200 subscribers right now, which is really cool. I mean, we just do this for fun, so it's cool to see people supporting and interacting with the channel. So yeah, hope you guys have a great day, and we'll catch you next one. Fish on.